So we are testing the players for performance activities like broad jumps, sprinting, and things that measure how well they perform. But we're also testing things that look at the building blocks of that performance. These events are so important for players because you get to showcase your skills, but also you get to find out how you can be better and the areas that you can work on to be a better player, because it's a continual process. So they start with getting their body measurements, where this is going to be height, seated height, their arm span, skin fold measurements. Then they're going to go into movement, where we're going to do a top tier selective functional movement assessment, which is just basically moving in different patterns, turning your head side to side. Then we're going to go through range of motion. We're going to look at range of motion throughout the whole body, shoulder, neck, your mid back, your hips, your ankles. Then we're going to do a functional movement screen, which is a higher level test that includes things like a push-up, a rotary stability, a deep squat. Then we go to a balance test with the Y balance test, and that tells us how you balance at the limit of your ability, your limit of stability. So we look at the broad jump, we look at the 30-yard sprint, we also look at your jumps with your hands on your hips and a counter movement jump. These jumps tell us how well you're performing, because it allows us to know how much power you're generating, because power is velo, whether it's hitting or pitching. And so these tests help us understand that. When you combine these tests with all of the other movement tests and range of motion tests, you can understand where to develop that player and how to develop that player.